and then the nanorobot get digested as it is a DNA-based product. I saw the product sample in one of the laboratories in South Korea, where best of minds with multiple technology work with target of finding out-of-box solutions. Now friends, convergence of science is reciprocating. Convergence of science is reciprocating. Let me give an example. Recently, I was in the Harvard University, where I visited laboratories of many eminent professors from the Harvard School of Engineering and Applied Science. They don't call it engineering faculty. They call it the Harvard School of Engineering and Applied Science. I recall how Professor Hokun Park showed me his invention of a nano needles. He discovered nano needles, which can pierce and deliver content into individual targeted biocells. That's how nanoparticle science is shaping the bioscience. Then I met Professor Vinod Manoharan, who showed, on the other hand, biosciences is in turn shaping into a nanomaterial science as well. He is using DNA material to design self-assembling particles. When particular type of DNA is applied on a particle at the atomic level, he is able to generate a prefixed behavior and automatic assembly from them. This could be our answer to self-assembly of devices and colonies in deep space without human intervention, as envisioned by Dr. K. Eric Drexler. Thus, within a single research building, I saw how two different sciences are shaping each other without any iron curtain between the technologies. This reciprocating contribution of sciences to one another is going to shape our future, and the industry needs to be ready for it. The curriculum designers of CHARUSAT University may like to take this aspect into account while formulating new courses. Now a new trend is emerging. The aspect being introduced is that of ecology. Globally, the demand is shifting towards development of a sustainable system which are technologically superior. This is the new dimension of 21st century knowledge society, where science and environment will go together. That's the new age. When you go out on this campus, that's the new age model would be a four-dimensional, not three-dimensional, four-dimensional, bio, nano, info, eco-based. Friends, I have in the last 10 years met more than 10 million, 12 million youth and faculty, more than 150 universities in India and 37 universities in abroad. Based on this interaction, I wish to formulate a 21st century university vision. 21st university, how this century, what is the new demands on 21st university vision for your consideration, for both young and experienced. According to me, the universities have to prepare citizens of the future with a global outlook and be capable of serving his or her nation or the nation of his or her choice. Science and technology, public policy are interrelated for mutual benefit and ushering in humankind's development. This link has to be solidly built in the university education. Good teachers can be any part of the world. The university has to bring in this resource through innovative content generation in virtual classroom. What we need is virtual classroom. Technological connectivities among universities have been pursued on a war footing using cost-effective virtual classrooms. Cost-effective continuing education possibilities are essential. Cost-effective because the universities are competitive now. Number of universities have come in. So cost-effective and quality education possibilities are essential for citizen to be in tune with time. Can university education lead to a sustainable development of the nation? The cry of the need today, sustained development of the nation. With the world population increasing and resources dwindling, a mindset has to be developed for conserving and sharing the resources and look for a new research for abundant resources. This called for a noble spirit as well as research spirit. Noble spirit and research spirit. In summary, 21st century university education is about developing enlightened citizenship for a knowledge society, for peace and prosperity of the nations and the world. 21st century university has to be an incubator of the world knowledge powerhouse. Based on my interaction with the Indian and foreign university, I have detected certain dynamics which I have shared with you. Finally, friends, in conclusion, I would like to ask you what you would like to be remembered for. You know, you all graduated now. Now you are entering into a career path or research path. I don't know what you will select. But anyway, you will not be employment seeker. You have to be employment generator. So friends, you have to evolve yourself. You have to evolve yourself and shape your life. You should write it on a page. I will go back again. Conclusion. Where are you? Finally, I would like to ask you, friends, what you would like to be remembered for? You have to evolve yourself and shape your life. You should write it on a page today. That page may be a very important page in the book of human history. And you will be remembered for creating that one page in the history of the nation. Whether that page is the page of invention, or the page of innovation, or the page of discovery, or the page of creating a societal change, or a page of removing the poverty, or a page of fighting injustice, or a page of finding innovative, cost-effective healthcare system, both preventive and curative. I'm sure you all would like to do something different, out-of-box mission. What are they? What will be the type of mission? I have given formula. Now I'm giving an example. Will you be remembered? Not only for graduating students, all youth who have assembled here. Will you be remembered for a visionary action for the nation? Like Professor Vikram Sarabhai, who belonged to this place, Gujarat, Homi Baba, Jamshedji Tata, or the milkman, that Mr. Korean, Dr. Korean. Will you be remembered for creating a company which finds a place in the top hundreds of Fortune 500 companies from India? Will you be remembered for facilitating creation of 100 puras, providing urban amenities to the rural area in your region, wherever you come from? Will you be remembered for becoming a pioneer in developing a smart waterway in the states and interlinking of the rivers in the nation? Will you be remembered for revitalizing or revolutionizing the integrated primary health care in public-private participation mode? Will you be remembered for working and creation of validated system for a production of 340 million tons of food grains and value addition through food processing by the year 2020, another 8 years' time? Will you be remembered for modernization of 10 million SMEs, small-scale industries, and the addition of another million by providing private equity funding ventures? Will you be remembered for a venture capital banker by introducing the unique private equity funding for the ideas that will bring new dimension to the society? Will you be remembered for bringing energy independence for the nation, like solar power, wind power, and biofuel, nuclear power? Will you be remembered Will he be remembered for the action-oriented clean home, clean environment, clean state, and clean nation? Finally, will he be remembered for developing 1 million enlightened youth in your region who will participate in the accelerated societal transformation of the nation? My best wishes to all of you graduates for success in all the missions of CHARUSAT University of Science and Technology in igniting the energy and ability of the youth to achieve transformation of changes that will benefit the nation. May God bless you all, friends.
I request the President to present a memento to the chief guest.
I will give the set of books to the library of your university, sir.
I request the President to give the presidential address. I request the President to present a memento to the chief guest.
India's Rishi, scientist, our chief guest, Dr. APJ Kalamji, Dr. M.C. Patel, Provost, Shri Nagin Bhai, member of the governing body, Board of Management, Devang, invited guest, staff, students of CHARUSAT, our valued donors, student receiving the degrees today and their parents. This is indeed a moment of pleasure and pride for all of us. The first convocations will remain an important milestones in the history of the CHARUSAT. On this auspicious occasions, I would like to congratulate the degree awardees as well as all gold medalists. The students who have received the degrees today are indeed very lucky. They are blessed because of the noble soul like Dr. APJ Kalam has come to bless them. You are lucky that your parents inspire, in spite of the all difficulties, have sent you to the university from the professional educations. In our countries, gross enrollment ratio at the present is only at 12%. This is to say, out of 100 eligibles, only 12 children get the chance to pursue the higher educations. Charu means goldens. Salt means truth. CHARUSAT has given you the golden truth in the terms of the degrees. As a universities, we have expectations from you. As our chief guest says, try to become a job creator and other than a job seekers. Though through your enterprise and leaderships, generate more employment. That is to be courageous to take the life challenges. Technologies have shrunk the world. Physical distance are diminishing. The globe will come be your workplace. Build the courage to take the challenges of the globalized workplace. We are thankful to you and your parents for selecting the CHARUSAT, do visit your alum mater and have a look for the progress. I would like to bless you with this word, Satyam Vada, Dharmam Chara, Svadhyayatma, Pravadiyatavyam, Parishram no koi vikalp nathi, Kuladipo Bhava, Rashtadipo Bhava, Evam Charusata Sansthata Arshivadam. Om Sarvesam Swastir Bhavatu, Sarvesam Shantir Bhavatu, Sarvesam Purnam Bhavatu, Sarvesam Mangalam Bhavatu. With the sense of the gratitudes to our chief guest, Dr. Kalam, all the governing body, board of the management of members, I declare the convocations closed.
I would like to express the gratitude. We express our heartfelt gratitude to Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam sir for gracing this occasion of first convocation and blessing the students. We are also thankful to his secretarial staff for all the facilitating. The governing body and board of management members are always guiding and supporting to CHARUSAT. We are very thankful to them also. Our sense of obligation extends to all our esteemed donors, without whose rock-like support this university would not have existed. We are also thankful to them. We are thankful to the donors of the gold medal, Shri P.D. Patel, Shri Devang Bhai Patel, Matru Sanstha, and Shri Pankaj Bhai Patel. The collector madam and the whole district administration, the police, PWD, GB, and all the other agencies have always been on the side of CHARUSAT, eager to help us. We express our gratitude to them. The management and the committee members and all the members of Kelavani Mandal and Matru Sanstha, their trustees, office bearers, and everybody, they have always provided us encouraging boost in all our initiatives and projects. We thank to them from the bottom of the heart. All the students, present students of CHARUSAT, and all the staff members of CHARUSAT.